Greetings, my brothers and sisters. This is Prophet Wes, Elder Wes, Brother Wes, Ernest Wes, whatever you want to call me. I'm coming back to you again, briefly. Everybody's settled. My son is back from the therapy. There's something, a quick word that I want to highlight, or a word that I want to get you to focus on in instructions, and that is, never let anyone rush you from doing what it is God has called you to do. Especially because, see, what happens sometimes when you connect or when you're with people, sometimes people become temperamental. People, they have their own purpose, they have their own mindset, they own their own way of doing things. And sometimes when you connect with people, sometimes their busyness or their weariness or their trials and tribulations, if you're not careful, they could, if you're too close to them, they could cause a rush you from doing certain things, because you can get out of certain things and go help them and leave where you are, and then you leave and then you disobey God. So basically, when you're with people in a partnership or whatever they're dealing with, whatever they're facing, make sure that their situation, their warfare is their warfare, not your warfare. Now, you can pray with them and pray alongside of them to encourage them in their warfare, but that is the thing that they have to deal with, they have to face, just like their warfares that you have to face. And in all of those things that we face in life, tribulations and stuff, the Bible said, tribulation work of patience, spirits and hope. And so we must remain patient in this step, in the things that you're going through, and don't rush through it. And see, this is why, one of the reasons why I'm saying, that's why God has been saying, be still and listen to him, is because at this place, many of you are very emotional. You're really emotional. You're really emotional because earlier I said, God was bringing out of you enough. And enough is when you get to a place where you become sick and tired of feeling a certain way, being in a certain position, and you won't change. You won't change. You want to get out of the situation. You want to get out of how you're feeling. You want to get out of the situation and the people that you're in. And many of you, there's certain things that you believe in God for and haven't come yet, but you keep still praying. And it's almost like your eyes are your affliction, because when you're praying, when your eyes are closed, when you're seeking God through faith, but when you open your eyes up, that prayer, it appears that it's not happened. It appears now it's going to take place, and you turn within. And you turn within, be careful of the voice from that rejection or the voices from that encounter. Be careful of those voices speaking to you and allowing you to turn within. See, many of you, when you become so frustrated and you keep believing God, And at a certain point, being tired, at a certain point of being frustrated, at a certain point of being weary, if you're not careful, it could turn within. It could turn within. Just like love. Love, if love isn't, when a person love and gets hurt, if they're not healed, if they're not given information, if God doesn't come into the situation and help you and get you to understand what love is, then that love will turn to hate. There's a thin line, peace, joy, all those things. And so it turns, because from the place of the contact, the point of contact of hurt, the point of contact of that situation that happened, when you don't deal with that situation, when you don't allow God to come in and bring self, healing self, heal you in that situation. But if you allow to ponder and wonder and keep thinking and keep thinking and keep thinking, what's happening, you're building a mindset. You're building a mind process, a process, the way you think. And the more you process a certain thing, the more you process a certain situation, the more you process a certain thing that you believe in God for, negative, then that process is going to become a voice. So be careful what you entertain. Even the Bible says, when a man looks at a woman as a lust at her with her heart, he's committed adultery already in his heart. So the entertainment, don't entertain thoughts. The Bible says when you submit yourself unto God, then you have the ability, once you submit yourself to God, the strength to resist the devil. He will flee. Those thoughts, those ways, those habits, those appetites, they will flee. But you must remain focused and trust him. My word for the day, encourage. Have a good day.